All right, so how are we going to figure this out?
By you letting them figure it out while I figure it out.
I think you should figure this out.
Okay, let's figure it out.
So it might not be obvious just looking at it blankly. So why don't we just throw in some values here? So for example, we can do this, which is gets filled in both places. So the probability that thunder is true, given lightning is false, and storm is true, what is that number?
Well, so we just have to find the place in our little eight-row table where lightning is false and storm is true.
Where lightning is false and storm is true,
Which is there.
Uh-huh.
And the probability that thunder is true is 0.04 divided by 0.4.
Oh, because we're asking about thunder. Right. So what's right. the probability that thunder is true given that the other two things, lightning is false and storm is true? So that's going to be divided by the 0.4. That's the setting that we're in.
Right. And 0.04 divided by 0.4 is 0.1.
Right. So maybe we'll get lucky and it'll work out the same with the other one. So where do we have to look for that one?
Well, now we have to look in the row where lightning is false and storm is false.
Okay. So it's down here.
And look at the case where thunder is true, and that's 0.03. And it's 0.03 divided by 0.3, which is also 0.1.
Woohoo! So that works as an answer. It turns out that, in fact, no matter what you type into these two boxes, it does, in fact, work. And what does that tell us?
Well, it tells us that it doesn't matter what the value of storm is. We can figure out the value of thunder by only looking at the value of lightning. So that is to say that the probability of thunder given lightning and storm is equal to the probability of thunder given lightning, or that we have conditionally independent variables.
Yes, that's right. Storm is conditionally independent of thunder given lightning.
Right. So if the probability of thunder given lightning and storm is equal to the probability of thunder given lightning, that means that thunder and storm are conditionally independent given lightning.
Or thunder is conditionally independent of storm given lightning.
Sure.
Very good. All right, so now what we're going to do next is say, okay, well, given that we have this nice property, and yeah, I worked a little bit to make sure that the numbers worked out. It doesn't always happen this way, but here we had some nice conditional independence, and what we're going to do next is look at a nice representation of that kind of information.